Thank you very much for the opportunity to come and talk about Statkraft's contributions to a greener economy. I hope that I'm able to show that Statkraft is developing renewable energy both in and outside of Norway, and that we are trying to deploy the latest results from the research community to improve and professionalize our core activities. Just a few words about Statkraft as an introduction in case some of you don't know the company. Statkraft is the leading, Europe's leader within renewable energy. We develop and generate hydropower, wind power, gas power, and district heating, and we are a major player on the European energy exchanges. Statkraft has more than 3,400 employees in more than 20 countries. Statkraft's strategy builds on several macro trends, all of which have been explained previously in this conference. There is a growth in energy demand, mainly driven by the non-OECD countries. There is a need to reduce greenhouse gas emissions to reduce global warming. And the European Union has set ambitious targets for the energy sector with an expected growth in renewable energy of about 600 terawatt hours by 2020. We also have a moderate power price and a low carbon prices in the EU. The need for clean energy creates major growth opportunities. Statkraft is uniquely positioned to take part in this growth. So projects will be developed internationally to meet increasing energy demand. And we will invest in projects in the Nordics and in Europe based on support schemes for renewable energy. Flexible production from the Nordic hydropower is Statkraft's main activity and includes more than 200 hydropower stations in Norway, Sweden and Finland. Nordic hydropower makes up the majority of our assets and revenues, and we will try to maintain our position as Europe's largest hydropower producer and be a major supplier of flexible power in Europe. Statkraft has a global strategy for hydropower, and the goal is to strengthen our position considerably in attractive growth markets. Statkraft has hydropower stations in Turkey, Albania and Laos, and through our subsidiary SN Power, we own hydropower plants in Peru, Chile, Brazil, India and the Philippines. Statkraft is working on opportunities for further growth in South and Central America, Asia and Africa. This picture is from Turkey, where we have three hydropower projects. One is under operation, and two are under construction. When it comes to wind power, the ambition is to establish Statkraft as one of the most profitable and cost-efficient operators in onshore wind power in Norway and Sweden. Currently, we have five onshore wind parks in operation. Three in Norway, one in Sweden, and one in the UK, with a total installed capacity of 276 megawatts. In addition, Statkraft has three wind parks under construction, two in Sweden and one in the UK. Statkraft's share of the installed capacity is about 130 megawatts, and the projects are scheduled for completion in 2012 and 2013. The total investment for these projects is about 2.8 billion Norwegian kroner. Statkraft has a large project portfolio within land-based wind in Norway and Sweden, where the priority is to achieve final licenses so that construction can start. Offshore wind power concentrates on the UK market. Statkraft and Statoil own the offshore wind farm Sheringham Shoal on a 50-50 basis. When completed, the wind farm will have an installed capacity of 317 megawatts, The wind farm is under construction, and last week, about 50 of the total 88 planned wind turbines were installed. The project is scheduled for completion in 2012. Statkraft is building capabilities and institutionalizing learning from the Sheringham Shoal project as a basis for taking a leading role in future offshore wind power projects. Together with three partners, the offshore wind projects at Dogger Bank are being developed towards the license application stage. The Dogger Bank projects have a total capacity of 9,000 megawatts. From gigantic offshore wind projects to more down-to-earth and renewable energy projects in Norway, Statkraft will strengthen its position as one of the largest companies in Norway within district heating. During 2011, Statkraft bought the company BioVarme, and Statkraft's portfolio of district heating systems now consists of about 20 units in Norway and Sweden. The largest district heating is located here in Trondheim, and I suspect that in this very hotel that the heat is delivered by Statkraft. Our aim is to grow further in Norway and Sweden through expansion and acquisitions. Statkraft considers small-scale hydropower to be attractive due to the large development potential in Norway. Statkraft will grow in small-scale hydropower through the shareholding Småkraft. Småkraft invests in and builds small-scale hydropower plants in partnership with local landowners. To the left, you see a picture from the district heating unit in Harstad, recently opened. And at the right, you see a standard small-scale hydropower station delivered by Småkraft. I think this one is from Voss. As you have seen, we have an ambitious growth strategy. There are, however, challenges when developing renewable energy in all markets. In Norway, the following challenges are particularly dominant. Obtaining concessions and licenses is difficult and time-consuming. It is not my intention to criticize, but it takes years and years to get the final consent for constructing a wind park or a small-scale hydropower unit. Connecting to the grid is the second challenge. Supply and demand is not always located in the same area, and transporting the electricity from power stations to the consumer is sometimes difficult. This is also linked to the challenge of obtaining concessions. We are also concerned about the market balance. As most analysts, Statkraft sees a large growth in supply and a more limited growth in demand in the Nordic electricity market. So there is a possible overcapacity in the market with depressed electricity prices as a consequence. In addition to growth activities, Statkraft is developing our core activities through research and development. The purpose of Statkraft's activities within innovation, technology, and research and development is to strengthen the company's competitive advantages within the core activities, and to monitor trends and developments that may influence the market that Statkraft operates in. Three long-term R&D programs have been established to strengthen the competitiveness of the company. These are future hydropower, competitive wind power, and energy from biomass. Statkraft is the largest industrial player in the scheme Centers for Environmental Friendly Energy Research, or the more commonly known as the FMEs. In addition, activities have been established in selected areas that may become new business opportunities in the longer term. Statkraft is world-leading in developing osmotic power. We opened the world's first osmotic power prototype at Tofte in 2009. Statkraft has set specific development targets for membrane and system efficiency and worked towards an investment decision for an osmotic power pilot of 1 to 2 megawatts by the end of 2013. Well, I hope I've been able to show that Statkraft is developing renewable energy, and we are trying to implement results from the research community to improve and professionalize our core activities. Statkraft contributes to a greener economy by providing pure energy, which also happens to be our vision statement. Thank you very much for your attention.